Hi everybody and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is my first video in English, so sorry about that. I hope my English will improve in the next videos. Today we have an unboxing. This is the Lewitt DTP640 Rex microphone. For everyone who doesn't know this company, Lewitt is an Austrian company with a factory in China who makes very good quality microphones with sometimes unique characteristics at affordable prices. They are 10 years old now, which is not so much in this business, but they have a lot of models for studio and also for stage. This DTP640 Rex is the flagship model in their drum kit. It's a microphone designed for kick drum, but we can also use it with bass amps, double bass and some other low frequency instruments. So let's open the box and see what's inside. Here we have the user manual. The warranty card. A sticker, a leather pouch, maybe too small. We have a Y cable that I'm going to explain what's for later. A small screwdriver and the microphone itself. It's heavy and seems really well made, as we expect, because it costs around $350. Maybe you are thinking that it's expensive, because this D112 costs around $100 and this Beta 91A around 280 more or less. But what you don't know yet is that in this mic we have that two mics in one. As we can see, it has two capsules inside. This one is dynamic, as the D112 for the punch and classic kick sound, and this one is the condenser one, as the Beta 91, for the body and clarity in low frequencies. They are aligned to avoid phase issues. Here comes the cable that I showed you before. As you can see, this output connector is a 5-pin connector. So this cable converts this 5-pin output into two 3-pin outputs to record and mix both signals separately. In the cable we have marked the condenser side and the dynamic side. Here we can see two switches. We need the screwdriver to use them. Like this. This switch is a 10 or 20 dB pad, only for the condenser capsule, and this other switch is for what they call EFR, enhanced frequency response. In the first position, both capsules are completely flat. In the second one, the dynamic has a boost between 70 and 150 Hz and between 3 and 5K. The condenser remains flat. In the last position, we have the dynamic focused between 3 and 5K and the condenser between 70 and 150 Hz. This last one is better for kick drum, or that's what they say. So we have the punch in the dynamic side and the low end and clarity in the condenser side. Well, so here's the unboxing. Soon I want to try it in a drum recording session, and then I will show you the results. Take a look to other Lewitt microphones, because they sound really, really well. Please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel and my blog. See you in the next video. Bye.